Good morning, dear students. Welcome to all of you to today's alternative English class. Before starting the class, let's do Brahmanath. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So dear students, today we are going to start a chapter named My Mother. This chapter is in unit 2 of your alternative English, that is Man and Woman. Okay, and this one is being written by Neeraj Chandra Chaudhary, and Neeraj Chandra Chaudhary belongs to India. He is an Indian writer and he has taken birth in the year 23rd of November 1897 and died on 1st August of 1999, and he is an Indian writer as well as commentator on culture. Means on culture he has given very critical opinion. Understood? So, Anglo-Indian writer, being an Indian, writing in English. Okay? So look, chapter's name is My Mother, not My Mother, Writer's Mother. Okay? So here the writer has focused briefly and clearly on his mother. Then you might be thinking, what is the theme of this chapter? Look, normally we also know our mother. Sometimes our mother is in high temper, sometimes she is cool like ice, some other times she is strict, yes or no? So we have seen various pictures, various images of our own mother. So likewise, Neeraj Chandra Chaudhary has mentioned his mother in a different way, and he has put or he has collected number of qualities that his mother was having. Okay? While study, you just go line by line, otherwise you can't understand it. My father and mother were bound to each other by common principles. Okay, so here the writer has spoken that his father as well as his mother, they were having some common characteristics, some common principles and standards of conduct, but otherwise in appearance, temperament and outlook, they were the reverse of it. So what has the writer mentioned? He has mentioned that his father and mother, they both are having some common characteristics in them. Otherwise, in their appearance, or definitely in appearance it will be changed. So in appearance, in temperament. Temperament means, I have written all the word meanings here. You can write it down. If some other word meanings that you are finding it difficult, you can ask me. So temperament means nature of thinking, their thinking way. In appearance, temperament and outlook, they were the reverse of it. Reverse means opposite of it. So they were having some common principles, otherwise they are completely different from each other. Who is speaking? The writer is speaking on his parents. If one chooses to say the same thing in a different way, the complement of each other. It means if a single subject is there, they both will give their opinion in two different ways. Okay? It means both are part and parcel or complement to each other. My mother was as slight and fragile as my father was robust, and his mom was quite weak and his father was quite strong. Okay, very means strong at brain. Here it is not referring to the physical appearance, it is here nature, temperament is being focused. While her face was responsive as my father's was impassive. Responsive meaning is what? Able to receive. Means if you speak something to the writer's mother, from her facial expression it will be clear that she can understand you or she can receive whatever you are speaking. But his father, completely reverse of it. Okay? And his father's face was not revealing any emotion. As you see him, you will feel that this is the man without any feeling, without any emotion. Okay? It rippled to emotion as waters to the wind. And from the face of the writer's mother, you can clearly see that the writer's mother was having too much emotion in her. Means her face bears the mark of emotion as if water is rippling. Okay, it means there are water wavelets. Okay, likewise, the emotions are completely reflected on the writer's mother. It was quite out of the question for her to try to hide any feeling, because on her part, it was not at all possible to hide anything. Means whatever it was completely focused, completely reflected on her face. We always saw at a glance whether she was angry or pleased and regulated her movements accordingly. This work the writer was not only doing, everyone was doing and are also doing. Listen, sometimes if something is there in your mind, suppose your school is going on a picnic, all your classmates are going and you have to go and you have to take permission from your parents, and after reaching home you notice that your parents are having a fight, they are in an angry mood, will you speak? Definitely not, because if you speak on that very moment, they will reject your idea, yes or no? So at that time you will wait for the proper time to speak, and the writer was also doing the same thing, means their action was completely regulated by her feelings, by her temperament, okay? Means the writer was also watching what is the mood of the mother, then only he was speaking something. Altogether, she was always vivid and high strung. And what is mentioned, that he was always vivid. Vivid means what? Clear. And high strung means anxious. And means her face, it was clear that she was having the eagerness to know each and everything. And her impression was quite clear. And if not hectic and electrical, she was not hectic and not electrical, but she was quite clear. Even when she was young, there were two deep vertical wrinkles between her eyebrows. Look, here there are two vertical wrinkles, okay? And even when the mother was quite young, still she was having the wrinkles. And it was the belief that you will have the wrinkle due to your age. But no, what the writer has mentioned, which is normal cases would have signified a bent of thought. But here, it is not because of age. The mom was always thinking. She was always busy in thinking something. That's why the wrinkles were present there. But my mother was not intellectual. Although when she chose to be argumentative, she could be devastatingly logical. And his mother was not having any argument with people. But whenever she was having the argument, she was devastatingly logical. Means she was at any cost, she was winning in the logic. Means she was quite strong in argument. Her natural propensity was intuitive, and those wrinkles were produced by the frequent fits of introspective brooding, means thinking, into which she fell. And what is mentioned, that her natural tendency, propensity, tendency, intuitive means spontaneous. Her spontaneous tendency to think something, because of this region, she was having this wrinkle. And she was always thinking, busy in brooding. Brooding means thinking. She was not handsome. Look, here it is mentioned, the word handsome near the girl, whether it is correct or not. It is correct. This is not wrong. You can use it. She was not handsome, but no more she was plain. She was not very handsome, means not very good looking, but she was not plain also, means not very simple. Her forehead was very well shaped. Forehead was well set without being high, and the forehead was not high. It was well set, properly marked. And the oval of her face was broad in the upper half, but very quickly receding and tapering in the lower. So what is mentioned? This part was quite broad and this part was quite thin. Okay, so this part was quite low and it was a perfect mark. Look here in your book, 1, 2 and 3 blank spaces are there. In activity number 8, you can see A, B, C, D. Okay, 4 paragraphs are there. And you need to provide appropriate paragraph in the appropriate place. So the first one is, her eyes were large and liquid. Liquid means watery eyes. Her eyes were quite large as well as liquid eye. Her nose very regular and prominent. Nose was also very prominent. Her lips swell. Well cut tending towards fullness in the lower one. The real weakness of the face was the chin, which though neatly set was not weighty enough for the upper part. Means look, her face was completely good, but this part, the chin part, was quite little bit less. Means it was not heavy up to this much. Okay, this is the facial features of the writer's mother. Taken in their entirety, means the whole, her feature gave an impression of on-sleeping alertness and inexhaustible animation. Means she was not getting tired. Okay, and from her face, it was clear that it was giving on-sleeping alertness, means she was always alert for something. By nobody would that face have been called a face of simple and honest goodness alone. And no one can speak that the face was very simple, very honest. Okay, means even when you see it, you can, to some extent, you can realize that's quite critical, quite clumsy. The openness, goodness, and generosity which was obvious in that countenance were of an extremely restless, positive, and winged type, and the expression on her face was restless, positive, and winged type. It was quite good also. But here, again, the appearance was deceptive, means, but the appearance was quite misleading, means from the appearance of the writer's mother, you can't have a clear-cut idea on her nature. For her face did not so hardly indicate it, even the immense strength of her moral conviction. Conviction means what? Strong belief. Because she was having very strong moral belief, from her face it was not at all clear, it was not at all visible, but morally she was very strong. No one could have inferred from her face that she was capable of some fanaticism. Fanaticism means what? Someone fanatic. Okay, fanaticism means the act of confining, or means inclined to a particular religion. Okay, means you are attached to a single religion and you are speaking that all others are bad and yours one is good. That one is fanaticism. So, no one could have inferred from her face that she was capable of such fanaticism as she sowed over questions of right and wrong. And she was, to some extent, she might be quite superstitious and she was quite fanatic, but it was not at all visible from her appearance that she was too much fanatic. Even more than my father was the intolerant of demonstrativeness and the wearing of one's heart on one's sleeve. And here what is mentioned means if they compare the father and the mother, then it was quite clear that she was openly displaying and she was showing her feelings openly and correctly, and she was also capable to control, to dominate, okay, by her arguments as well as by her beliefs on morality. Okay, understood it? Look, there are 5 or 6 paragraphs. I am teaching you only 2 or 3. You just read it. Watch the video. So watch the video, and any doubt you have, you just ask me. So here, in this chapter, what is the theme? I taught you only 2-3 paragraphs, okay? Here the theme is that the writer has given a clear-cut picture of its mother. What is the attitude of the mother, the temperament of mother, and what is the common characteristics in between the father and mother, and what is the basic difference in between them is also clearly emphasized. And the writer has also focused that his mother was quite fanatic and she was having the power, she was having the ability to wear one's sleeve. It means she was quite dominating in nature whenever there is the argument. Okay, read it. Any doubt, you ask me. Thank you. Have a nice time.